I remember the first time my son said, "Mom, are you taking your big bag or your little bag?" And that was his question of, how long are you going to be gone for?
Yeah.
I had gotten my first grant. I went to the field. I cried the whole plane ride when I left, and I missed his first Christmas. But when I got back, he snuggled right in.
I had my son in 2011, so you were the pioneer, and I had to ask you a lot of questions. The biggest question I had was if your son remembered you when you came back after being gone.
When you asked me that, I remember thinking I didn't necessarily have good advice. We're scientists. We want data. And we don't have that.
When I did get back home, my son didn't recognize me. He sort of recoiled when I went to go have my imagined moment of us running into each other's arms. You know, I wondered if I had done the right thing.
Yeah.
I had one instance that I still sort of struggle with. Someone I respect as a scientist immensely. Unsolicited, he said to me, "You know, I was in the field a lot, and I was always grateful that my wife stayed home with the kids because kids need their mothers." He very pointedly wanted to let me know that he felt that that was very important. But kids also need their fathers, and you don't hear that a lot.
Yeah. I think I'm a better scientist because I'm a mother, because I work harder in the field. If I'm away from my children, there's an extra weight that I have to do even better.
Just recently, I wanted to do an extra trip to the South Pole. And the way I had phrased it to my husband was, "You know, honey, they might need someone to go to the South Pole to drill some ice cores." And my son actually piped up and he said, "Mommy, you can do that." And so there was a moment where I felt like things would be okay, that my son actually understands what I do is important and is kind of proud of me.